on miracles as a confirmation of the claims of Christ and the biblical prophets and apostles. Contrasts with presuppositional and evidential apologetics. Classical apologetics differs from various forms of presuppositional apologetics in its handling of proofs for the existence of God and its use of historical evidence. Classical differs from evidential apologetics over whether there is a logically prior need to establish the existence of God before arguing for the truth of Christianity, e.g., the deity of Christ and inspiration of the Bible. See Christ and deity of. Classical apologetics is characterized by two basic steps. Its first step is to establish valid theistic arguments for the truth of theism apart from, but with appeal to, special revelation in Scripture. Its second step is to compile historical evidence to establish such basic truths of Christianity as the deity of Christ and the inspiration of the Bible. The use of the resurrection of Christ often plays an important role in this second step. Validity of theistic proofs. Classical apologetics accepts, and presuppositionalists reject, the validity of traditional theistic proofs for God. Some presuppositionalists replace traditional proofs with transcendental arguments for God of their own, see presuppositional apologetics, Van Til and Cornelius. Not all classical apologists accept all the traditional proofs for God. For example, many reject the validity of the ontological argument. But most accept some form of the cosmological argument and the teleological argument. Many also believe the moral argument is valid. Presuppositional apologists reject the validity of theistic proofs for God, see God and evidence for. Most of them accept the validity of much of what David Hume and Immanuel Kant said in their critiques of theistic argumentation, see God and objections to proofs for. Some, such as Gordon Clark, do this on the basis of empirical skepticism. Cornelius Van Til and others do it because they believe facts have no meaning apart from the presupposed Trinitarian worldview. Whatever the grounds, all true presuppositionalists join atheists and agnostics in rejecting the validity of traditional theistic proofs for God, see agnosticism, atheism.